The orbicularis retaining ligament, also known in the oculoplastic literature as the orbitomalar ligament, is the main periorbital retaining ligament. It is an osteocutaneous ligament that originates from the periosteum of the orbital rim, traversing the orbicularis oculi muscle and inserting into the skin of the lid-cheek junction. In 1963, Hagris described a facial extension that passed from the orbital rim to the orbicularis muscle and skin. Kikuwa et al. Was the first to describe this ligament anatomically and histologically, and they named it the orbitomalar ligament. Histological analysis showed that the ligament fanned out in a lamellar fashion as it traveled through the orbicularis oculi and the SMAS to the skin, similar to the retinacular cutis. Muzaffar et al. Detailed the anatomic description of this ligament and renamed it the orbicularis retaining ligament. His characterization of this retaining ligament was conceptually similar to that by Kikuwa et al. They said that the ligament is a septal structure originating from the periosteum just outside the inferior orbital rim, in close proximity to the septum orbitale, and inserting on the deep surface orbicularis oculi muscle. In a recent anatomic study, Wang et al. Confirmed the presence of a well-defined ligament in this medial adherent area of the orbicularis, which they named the tear trough ligament. This ligament originates from the maxillary periosteum immediately inferior to the orbital rim, sandwiched between and separating the origins of the palpebral and orbital portions of the medial orbicularis oculi muscle. It terminates at the medial corneoscleral limbus, where it becomes continuous with the orbicularis retaining ligament. Gavami et al. Confirmed the circumferential nature of the orbicularis retaining ligament in a cadaver study using an operating microscope. The ligament was noted to be present over the superior orbital rim as a distinct structure, separate from the septum orbitale. Wang et al. Named this superior portion of the orbicularis retaining ligament the periorbital septum of the upper orbit. Above, left. The orbicularis retaining ligament is most easy to identify laterally using the vertical spread technique, after which it can be traced medially along the orbital rims. Below. Schematic depicting the orbicularis retaining ligament, ORL, as a circumferential structure of the orbit that follows the orbicularis oculi muscle, OM, fibers, and is associated with the lateral orbital thickening, LOT. Above, right. The orbicularis retaining ligament of the medial orbit is seen clearly in both the superior and inferior orbits. The orbicularis retaining, ORL, ligament is separate from the orbital septum. The orbicularis retaining ligament spans the entire circumference of the orbits from the medial to lateral canthus. Retaining ligaments of the cheek and mandible. Furness was the first to describe the anatomy of the retaining ligaments of the cheek. His description included the zygomatic, anterior platysmocutaneous, mandibular, and platysmoauricular ligaments. The zygomatic cutaneous ligaments are strong fibers that originate at the inferior border of the zygomatic arch and extend anteriorly to the junction of the arch and body of the zygoma. Zygomatic cutaneous ligaments are found along the zygomatic arch, initiating in front of the tragus and found above and or below the zygomatic arch. Diamonds, zygomatic cutaneous ligaments, blue diamond, anterior platysma cutaneous ligament, Furness 1989. Asterisk, zygomatic arch. Heart, skin flap. Clover, superficial musculoaponeurotic system. These ligaments can take the form of fibrous septa, mainly posteriorly along the arch, and can have a cylindrical shape closer to the origin of the zygomaticus major muscle. The zygomatic ligaments are considered true ligaments due to their direct attachments to dermis. This is manifested by skin dimpling that occurs when the surgeon pulls on the cutaneous end of the cut ligament. Mendelssohn et al. Described zygomatic ligaments medial to the junction of the arch and body, located along the origins of the facial expression muscles, the zygomaticus major, zygomaticus minor, and levator labii superioris. These ligaments are weaker and often can be disrupted by blunt finger dissection. The zygomatic ligament, black arrow. A. Presygomatic space. B. Orbicularis retaining ligament. C. Orbicularis oris muscle. D. Malar fat pad. E. Zygomatic major muscle, F. Buccal fat pad. The masseteric cutaneous ligaments arise from the masseteric fascia over the masseter muscle. Their relationship to the muscle is controversial. The masseteric ligament, black arrow. A. Zygomatic major muscle, B. Facial vein, C. Masseter muscle. While some anatomic studies have shown the ligaments arising along the anterior border of the masseter, others have shown them to arise 1 to 2 cm posterior to the anterior border and even from the middle portion of the muscle. Owsley described the masseteric ligaments as a vertical septum, while other authors, although they did not directly address the morphology or structure, seemed to address them as individual ligaments. This ligament exists along the anterior border of the masseter muscle. Diamonds, masseteric cutaneous ligaments. Heart, skin flap. Clover, superficial musculoponeurotic system, SMAS. The term McGregor's patch has been used in the literature to describe the zygomatic ligaments. K referred to the McGregor's patch as an adherent area over the malar eminence. Furness used the term synonymously with zygomatic ligaments, and so did other authors. Schematic illustration of McGregor's patch. This patch is composed of a perforator of the transverse facial artery running towards the malar area, zygomatic ligaments, and upper masseteric ligaments. Stuzen et al. Used the term to describe the fibers comprising the zygomatic ligament extending through the malar fat pad, which they also named a fibrous McGregor's patch. Owsley described the McGregor's patch as dense facial septi that extends from the zygoma, penetrates the superficial fascia, and inserts into the dermis. McGregor's patch contains zygomatic and masseteric ligaments. Yellow diamond, zygomatic cutaneous ligament. Blue diamonds, masseteric ligaments. Green arrowheads, perforators of the facial artery. Heart, skin flap. Clover, SMAS. Practical pearl according to McGregor. In doing a facelift procedure, if it is not necessary to extend your undermining beyond McGregor patch, you are safer to stop before cutting through. As soon as you cut through this McGregor patch, you lose the protection of the parotid fascia on your deep side and you will see loose fat with branches of the facial nerve looking at you, hopefully intact, running through the loose fat, a little deeper and a little caudal. Is the parotid duct as stated above. It should be noted that when McGregor described this patch, none of the retaining ligaments of the face had been discovered or named. On the basis of these facts, we recommend that the term McGregor's patch, other than having a historical significance, should have no place in the modern anatomic terminology of the retaining ligaments of the face. Platysma auricular ligament / fascia. Furness described the platysmo-auricular ligament as arising from the parotid fascia and anchoring the posterior border of the platysma to the anterior inferior preauricular skin. The anterior platysmocutaneous ligament, Furness 1989. A trapezoidal fibrous tissue exists between the ear lobe and the posterior border of the platysma muscle. Diamond, platysma auricular ligament, auricle platysma ligament. Heart, parotid masseteric fascia, deep fascia. Clovers, the superficial musculoponeurotic system is reflected. According to the classification by Stuzen et al., this ligament is considered a parotid cutaneous ligament. It is the first ligament encountered during a facelift procedure. The other parotid cutaneous ligaments arise from the parotid fascia over the parotid gland and vary in size, density, and configuration depending on the size and extent of the parotid gland. Mendelssohn expanded the description of the platysmo-auricular ligament to include an area of adhesion over the parotid gland extending just anterior to the ear cartilage for 25 to 30 mm. He named this area the platysma auricular fascia. Algol and Codner mistakenly noted in their article that Mendelssohn coined the term platysma auricular fascia, PAF. In reality, Furness named the platysma auricular fascia, and even in the article, Mendelssohn reported that the PAF combines the part of the SMAS layer between the ear cartilage and the posterior edge of the platysma. Mandibular ligament.